Hello everyone, welcome to Apollo 24/7's YouTube channel. On occasion of World Heart Day, we have Dr. Tripti Deb with us, who will tell us the lifestyle routine that one should follow.
As 29th September is the World Heart Day, and we want, as a cardiologist, to keep each and every heart healthy. So what are those common tips which everyone should follow right from their childhood to their adulthood and in their mid-age to prevent early heart damage and early heart attack? This starts from the childhood. A small child also should not be given too much of fatty food, too much of oily and junk food like pizza, burgers, etc. So everyone, not only the adults and the youngsters, they should avoid the commercial items in the food. Every person should take a healthy food. What is healthy food? Healthy food is from nature, like organic vegan diet, that is totally plant-based. Means all the fibers and vegetables, fruits, greens, salads, sprouts should come from the plant-based and without changing their nutritive value, which is natural. Second thing comes that how to prevent atherosclerosis, that is the blockages in the arteries, to prevent it right from the beginning. For that, diet is very important. Exercise, taking enough water every day, like 3 to 4 liters water, and avoiding, as I have told you, all kinds of junk foods, and regular sleep. People forget to sleep. Nowadays, children have so much of stress. The stress is the biggest factor which causes inflammation of the arteries and which causes the plaque formation. The inflammation can be prevented by taking proper sleep of 8 to 10 hours without compromising into that and avoiding the stressful situations. So that I always stress to everyone not to do any hurry. No worry and no curry. No hurry, no worry and no curry. These three mantras are very important. In that, you are preventing your stress level, you are preventing the unnecessary junk food, you are preventing the hurry, means the very unnecessary stressful situations. Third thing is to take proper exercise. What is proper exercise? 5 days in a week, 35 to 40 minutes regular, like start from the warm up, stretching, then go for cardio aerobic or walking or outdoor games. First warm up your body. Don't suddenly start doing a running on the treadmill. Most of the youngsters, they do this mistake. They start doing running, jogging. Suddenly doing any exercise can build up a plaque rupture. Hence, first do a proper conditioning of warm up and stretching, etc. Then go for the cardio aerobic, gradually improving. Don't go beyond the heart rate of 140 per minute. Always keep it within 120 to 140. If you go beyond the 140 heart rate, then it is a stress to the heart because you are functioning at a anaerobic phase. Up to 120 to 140 heart rate, you are functioning at a aerobic phase of the exercise. So we don't want to build up lactic acid in your blood and causes stress in the blood pH. Third thing, very important, do a regulated lifestyle. That is regular meditation, regular yoga, pranayama, and the dietary modifications as I have explained. Fourth thing is very important to check your blood pressure regularly, every 6 months, third month, every year, so that you don't get a victim of a silent heart attack, because blood pressure is a silent killer. Most of the patients, they don't understand that nowadays we get a high blood pressure at the age of 10 years, 20 years, 30 years, very common. Previously, it was not like this. This is the stress of the modern society, which is pushing our children and youngsters to high blood pressure at a very young age. What is high blood pressure? It should not go beyond 120 systolic, maximum 130 systolic, and lower one should be 70 to 80. So 120, 80 to 130, 80 is the normal blood pressure. It should not go beyond 130, 80 because blood pressure is a silent killer. Then coming to the fifth, that is smoking, alcohol, abuse of the drugs. All these things causes early plaque buildup. So tobacco should be totally abandoned for everyone. Not even hookah, not even a small puff, not even a passive smoking present in the same room. So that should be totally prohibited. Now the fifth thing I would like to speak about the COVID. We are going through this pandemic and every person, even the youngsters, after even a mild COVID infection also, not a very major, at the home quarantine, after that, once they recover, there is a syndrome which is known as long COVID syndrome. Why it happens? Because every youngsters feel very weak. They can't get back to their work. There is a heartbeat which goes above 100, 110, 120. They feel palpitations. They feel anxiety. They feel very stressed out. And they are not feeling good to get back to their work. Then what should you do in that situation? You must contact a good physician or good cardiologist and do certain tests, because in long COVID syndrome, sometimes we see myocarditis, and that could be one of the reasons of such symptoms of irregular heartbeats also. So there are certain tests, regular ECG taking, echocardiogram, HS drop by high sensitive troponin I blood test, which is very important to see for any damage to the heart muscles, and if necessary, a 24 hours Holter monitor recording to check out the heartbeats in next 24 to 48 hours if there is any irregularity which could be prevented. There are certain conditions where post-COVID patients can develop more coagulation, that is clotting of the blood, because the clotting factors increases. How to check? Check for D-dimer test. Your physician will ask you to do a D-dimer and a CRP test to find out whether there is inflammation going on or there is any occult or there is any silent kind of clotting or blood thickening is going on in your body, so that you can prevent it much earlier if the levels are within range, or if they are high, you can take certain precautionary medication. And these are all preventable things which can be prevented easily.
For any heart-related concerns that you have, you can consult an Apollo expert by downloading Apollo 24/7 app now.